हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज क्लास 12th कंप्यूटर साइंस चैप्टर 5 फाइल हैंडलिंग लेक्चर नंबर 11। इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैड स्टडीड अबाउट बाइनरी फाइल्स एंड आल्सो लर्न अबाउट मेथड्स एंड इट्स मोड। आई गेव यू अ होमवर्क, सो हियर इज अ सॉल्यूशन ऑफ द होमवर्क। So question 1 says, what is binary file? The answer is, a binary file is a file stored in the binary format, and binary file is a computer readable but not human readable. All executable programs are stored in binary files, as are most numeric data files that you already studied. Next is, what are the methods of binary file? So these are the methods of binary file that you have to write in your notebook. Okay, so these are the work of previous class. So in this class, we will discuss about a new topic, that is Pickle module. We will learn this. Okay, this Pickle module is new for you. It is completely different as you have studied earlier. So what is Pickle module? So that pickling is a process whereby a Python object is converted into a byte stream. Means everything, whatever you are writing in the system, that is stored in the form of the byte. This Pickle module is applied only with the binary file, not with the text file. Okay, so it will convert it into the byte stream. And unpickling, that is a reverse of this, that whereby a byte stream is converted back into an object. Okay, that is, pickling is also known as serialization, marshalling or flatting. Okay, these all are the alternative name of pickle. So for using pickling, you have to import the pickle module. Okay, so next is the functions of pickle module. So as you are reading and writing from the file, same way pickle has also some functions for reading and writing. The first one is the dump statement. That is this function, dump function. Dump function is used to write a pickled representation of object to the open file, object file. Okay. Whenever you want to write anything, then you have to use the dump function. Next is load function. If you want to read a string from the file, then you have to use the load function. Read a string from the open file object and interpret it as a pickled data stream, reconstructing and returning the original object. This is the load function. So before going to start to the next slide, just let's move to the program. Here is your simple program. Just see what the program says. Here I have opened the file in binfile.bin. WB means you are writing in binary file. Here is the list, this num 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. This is a list and the variable is num. This array ARR is byte array num. What it will do? It will convert this list into the byte form and then you will write in the file. So here I am writing this f.write ar into the f object. Okay. Then I have closed the function. I am reading the function and it will give you the answer. So now it is showing the result. Okay, but you just see what happened if I just do not include this statement. Then I am just writing this. So it will not take the list into the file. It will not write directly the list in the file. Okay, just see what will happen. It will generate an error. The error is a bytes like object is required, not list. Means it requires a byte object, not the list. I think is it clear now that why I am using this array object. Okay. So to convert anything in the byte, there is a function that is byte array. It will also return a byte and it will represent it representation of the object. Okay. So it will convert this list in the byte form and then we are able to write this content into the file. Okay, this is the byte of array program. Now your next program is regarding the pickle module. Okay, just see Here I am importing this pickle module. Now f equal to open binary.det in writing mode. Now num, num1, these are the two lists, and this dict is the dictionary. So here I am using this dump module. This dump module will take two arguments. Okay, one is the variable, okay, and the second is the object, that what you want to add in the file. Okay, so this is the dump function. I am using three dump function, three write statement, then I have closed this. Now I am reading the file. Just see, I am reading the file. I am using this try and except. Okay, if you have seen my previous video, in that video I have written a program that is read a text file line by line. So here where I used while loop, that will infinite while loop, and that will that read all the lines, and when the end of line will reach, then the loop will just come out from the loop. Okay, here if I am using this while true, if you are not using this try, then you are using this infinite loop. When the end of file will reach, it will generate an error. Okay, so we, if you want to remove, if you want to avoid that error, you do not want to generate that error, then you have to use the try and the except. So here now see, when this try will execute, then the cursor will come here in the while block. It is infinite loop. So s equal to pickle dot load, it will read the file and print s. So one by one it will read all the three files and then print, and when the error generate, then it will go to the except. This except has EOF error. Now see children, this is a keyword. Okay, so do not, you have to just write it same. Okay, EOF is in capital letter, this E is in capital letter, you cannot change it, capital into small and small into capital. Okay, you have to write it same. So this is the except. When this print statement generate and end of line will reach, then cursor will come here in the except statement, and this end of line will generate, and you, the this except will close the file. Okay, and if you want to give any message, you can give any message also. For example, at the end, at the end. Okay, so this message will come at last. So I am going to run it. Now it will give you the data as it is storing in the file, and at the last it will give you the message. Okay, so next is your homework. So your homework is, you have to write a program by using this pickle module and its functions. Its function is dump and load. You have to write any simple program. Okay, so thank you and have a nice day.